Okay, we are now recording. Welcome to SNHS Movie Night. We're so happy that all of you attended. This event is hosted by the Outreach and Trips Committee, which is me, Sneeka, and Olivia. I'm Ruby. I'm part of the Outreach Committee.
Hi, I'm Sneeka. I'm a part of the Outreach Committee as well. And today we're just going to be watching a movie called Dream Big. And we're just probably, you know, we're expecting some more people. So we're going to hang around for a little bit more and then we'll get watching soon.
I feel like we might want to start because just for sake of time, because I feel like it's a little bit of a long movie. So,
okay, yeah, if we start, I'm Olivia and I'm from the Trips Committee. Sneeka, can you go to the movie? So today we'll be watching Dream Big, which is the first giant screen film to answer the call of the STEM, which stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math Initiative, which aims to inspire kids of diverse backgrounds to become the innovators who will improve the lives of people across our entire planet as we head into the 21st century and beyond.
And then also, we just want to give you a heads up. We're going to be having a discussion afterwards, so you guys should be paying attention and you should be able to answer basic questions about it when we're done.
Yeah, we're just going to basically just have a little discussion about it. Just to, you know, recap everything that we're talking about. And I will start playing the movie right now. It's on YouTube if you guys want to watch it yourselves. It's just called Dream Big, Engineering Our World. Okay? Also, guys, can you let me know if I mute myself? Can you still hear? Okay, so I'm going to give it a try right now, okay? Can you hear it at all?
Oh, when you do the screen share, there's this option. And then sharing audio, you did that? Okay.
Okay, hold on. I figured out what the problem was. Okay. I'm going to mute myself. Tell me if you.
We can hear it, yeah.
Sorry. Okay, I will start from the beginning and have fun, enjoy the movie, and we'll come back after the movie is done.
Learn by doing, by building, by creating. Those of us who dream big can carry that joy of creativity all through our lives. Bechtel is proud to present Dream Big.
Zero.
We never really saw our world until they showed it to us. Through the power of imagination, they astonish us. They're called engineers. With each life-changing creation, like the International Space Station, engineers enhance the human experience. They build civilizations. Every bridge, every building grows from an engineer's imagination. There are now 7 billion of us. And by 2045, there will be 2 billion more. Where will we all live? Will we have enough clean energy? The boldest solutions start with the biggest dreams. Menzer Pelevan grew up in Turkey.
I was a girly girl. I was a lead in the school plays. I actually wanted to be an actress. Until I was 13 when everything changed. We lived in a high-rise building. I remember my mother waking me up, terrified that the building would come down. I remember watching the people suffering. From that moment on, I knew what I wanted to do. Today, I'm a professional engineer in Seattle, hoping to make structures safer during earthquakes. I love my job, and I want kids to be excited about engineering as much as I am.
Are you ready for an earthquake?
Yeah!
3, 2, 1, let's start slow. Which one is the
To design safer buildings, we study how soil moves during an earthquake.
The engineers test building prototypes on the big shake table. To learn more, Menzer studied countries like Nepal, where earthquakes can be severe.
Nepal is a very poor country where most of the houses were built without any engineering design. own houses, they're an accident waiting to happen.
In 2015, a massive earthquake struck Nepal. Thousand lost their lives. But some survived, including the miracle baby, buried in the rubble for 22 hours. To do her part, Menzer took time off from work and flew to Nepal to join a team of fact-finding engineers.
We collect data on ground failures before the evidence washes away. We need to work fast.
Namaste, Babu. Namaste. Ketcha.
Namaste. Namaste.
Different types of soils act differently. Some soils act like a jello. Others act like a liquid and lose all their strength. Farmers led us to a field where carrots popped out of the ground. A clue that this soil acted like a liquid during the earthquake. That's what we call liquefaction. I remember when I was 13. I know what these kids are going through. The emotional aftershock of an earthquake can last for years. This is why I became an engineer.
After leaving Nepal, Menzer went to San Francisco. Here, engineers had a unique challenge: designing the city's tallest skyscraper at a site prone to liquefaction. The engineers solved it from the ground up. Menzer's team tours the site where the engineers sunk massive concrete columns all the way down to bedrock to resist earthquakes. Keeping people safe has always been the heart and soul of engineering. The first emperor of China faced a problem. Mongol warriors were invading from the north. So the emperor's engineers began building something that would preserve their civilization for almost 2,000 years. The Great Wall grew to be 13,000 miles long, the largest structure ever built by humans. After centuries of erosion and earthquakes, much of the wall survives. Steve Burrows, an engineer from England, has come to investigate.
It's really tough to study the wall when it stands there right on a knife edge on the top of a mountain. But we have our ways. This is LIDAR, the laser imaging device. The LIDAR showed that the most precisely built parts are standing well today. However, miles away, badly built sections of the wall are also still standing. Why? 500 years ago, the builders added a secret ingredient to their mortar. It's sticky rice. Adding sticky rice and lime to the mortar, it makes the mortar more elastic because it allows the wall to stretch and contract depending on the temperature. Sometimes the best solution is the simplest. The one staring up at you from your dinner plate.
In Western China, across the highest bridges on Earth, people are moving from farms to cities. Shanghai is now the most populous city in the world. 24 million people. But there's a problem. No more space to build. Where can they all live? Engineers squeezed an entire urban district into one city block by going vertical. They envisioned China's tallest building, the Shanghai Tower, rising 128 floors high with space for 16,000 people. But the taller the structure, the more it flirts with Mother Nature. Each summer, typhoons blast the city. The Shanghai Tower would soon become a huge target. But the engineers had some tricks up their sleeve. By twisting the outer skin 120 degrees, the wind safely glides around the tower. Here, the problem of population density has been met, all thanks to the ingenuity of a twist. Wind is an intriguing challenge for engineers of all ages. Menzer makes a game of it.
Okay, this competition will count as 10 points, and the tallest skyscraper that resists the wind will get 5 extra. Yay, excited? All right. Now remember, planning is important. Before cutting, make sure what you're building.
Building these paper skyscrapers teach kids the most important thing. Engineering is fun.
In 1940, the newly opened Tacoma Narrows Bridge near Seattle earned the nickname Galloping Gertie. A moderate wind gusting to 40 miles an hour made the bridge bounce, resulting in collapse. Fortunately, no one was killed. Engineers learn from catastrophes. New insights about the impact of wind on suspension bridges have led to better designs. Near Menzer's home in Seattle, two safer bridges have replaced Galloping Gertie. A large bridge can connect people. And so can a small one. After graduating from college, a young bridge engineer had a choice to make. Accept a high-paying job or follow her heart. Today, Avery Bang leads a team of passionate engineers building footbridges in poor countries.
In Haiti, I worked with kids whose village was isolated. Just across the river was the only school, and they could see it. It was right there, but they just couldn't get to it.
Over the past decade, 50 people have drowned trying to cross this river. A man who grew up by the river, Fritz Tuisson, offered to help. He had a very personal stake in this bridge.
3 years ago, when our youngest girl needed medicine, Matilde, my wife, headed off to the clinic across the river. The river was very high that day. Now, I have 8 children to raise on my own. To get to school, my kids cross the river right where their mother drowned. Matilde was everything to them.
They needed a bridge.
At least it's going to be a really big bridge.
Our mantra is
keep it simple.
With this new hinge design Avery came up with, the crew can raise tall towers using nothing but ropes.
From horizontal to vertical.
A young Haitian engineer named Junior Pierre Louis has joined the team.
Working with local engineers like Junior has a ripple effect. Today, we're building one bridge. Tomorrow, they may build 10 more on their own.
Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday.
Avery's decision to follow her heart has had a huge impact. Her team of engineers has volunteered to build nearly 200 bridges where they're needed most. Similar engineering groups have built thousands more worldwide. Every waterway challenges engineers. For centuries, trains could climb Scotland's rugged hills. But boats? It once took an entire day for a boat to be raised here, using 11 cumbersome locks. But then, a team of visionary engineers reinvented the wheel, the Falkirk wheel. The arm with the heavier boat carries less water, so the wheel always remains perfectly balanced. It uses just a wee bit of electricity. Falkirk is frugal with electricity, but renewable energy holds an even brighter future. From their small town in Mississippi, these high school students will take the solar car they built themselves and compete in the solar challenge. Some of the kids have never been to the next county, much less Australia.
My name is Ajay Patel. I'm in the 10th grade, and this is my second year on the solar car team. I like the hands-on part where you can actually like drill and use our brains more and solve problems.
In the solar challenge, the world's top university teams will race 1,600 miles on solar power alone.
All the cars are kind of strange and elegant. They're really extreme and expensive. All of them except for one.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming.
It's seriously hot inside the car, 120 degrees Fahrenheit.
The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking.
Our new lithium batteries aren't holding a charge. By tilting the solar panels towards the sun, we were able to squeeze just a bit more power out of the batteries. Just enough to keep going. And we were proud to cross the finish line, even if we were the last ones.
Solar energy can power a single car or an entire city. The world's largest solar facility, the Ivanpah Solar Electric Generating System, reduces CO2 emissions by over 1,000 tons every day. Hundreds of thousands of mirrors slowly pivot to keep the hot spot focused on the boiler at the top. Water inside turns to steam and drives turbines, which produce electricity for our cities, like Phoenix, Arizona. Where Angelica Hernandez is an engineer working on renewable energy.
I feel like I've really got it all. You know, I have an amazing husband, I have a super cute baby, and a job as an engineer, which is one of my dreams. But you know, I didn't start out that way. I grew up on the poor side of town. My mom worked really, really hard just to get by. Then I went to Carl Hayden High School, where I met an amazing, inspiring teacher who changed my life, Freddie Legevardi.
So, I see one way you can solve this. You can stop your catapult.
I joined his after-school robotics class, and the problems weren't easy to solve, but Freddy always knew how to make it fun.
We'll need you in a higher trajectory. You're doing a good job.
Got this.
The kids were just having so much fun. They were learning so much. They didn't even realize that they were learning, and that was the best part.
They heard about a national underwater robotics competition in Santa Barbara, California, and on a whim, decided to enter.
Heads up!
We didn't have much funding, but if you can't be expensive, be clever. So we used cheap landscaping pipes. In robotics club, Brady taught us a system. Define the problem, come up with different solutions, and pick the best one. But the one problem we couldn't solve was the smell of the pipe glue. It just stunk. So we named our robot Stinky.
Working, yeah!
Stinky was a bunch of pipe with a little bit of CPU and a whole lot of cables.
$6 and $800 later, Stinky was ready to go.
Hey guys, let's hurry up and get Stinky in here.
Sadly, Angelica had work commitments and had to miss the trip.
I was really disappointed, but, you know, I said my goodbyes. And off they went.
Stop me on the corner. Swear you hit me like a vision. I wasn't expecting. But who am I to tell fate where it's supposed to go with it? Don't you blink, you might miss it. See, we got a right to just love it or leave it. You find it and keep it. Cause it ain't every day you get the chance to see.
The team arrived in Santa Barbara the day before the competition. Some of the best engineering programs in the country compete, like MIT, the champs from the year before.
We're going with a mindset that we were going mainly as observers.
And if we beat just one college, that would be phenomenal.
When we arrived there, I mean, we looked like the carnival had arrived. Just a raggedy robot. Looked like we just pieced together everything from a junkyard.
Yeah, that's MIT.
The other robots were like pieces of underwater jewelry.
Yeah, I see.
They were chrome. They were stainless steel. They were manufactured plastic.
Hey,
These high school kids wanted to quickly test Stinky before anyone noticed him.
Robot was going left when they wanted to go right, wouldn't go up when they wanted to go up.
We had to figure out what was going on.
Freddie has always told his students, when you get in the jam, start asking smart questions.
We had a small leak, but no clue where it was.
If we can't find the leak, what can we do?
And then Lorenzo asked everybody, aren't tampons really absorbent?
This was a do or die kind of situation.
I got him!
Yeah!
It wasn't about building a robot. It was about learning how to learn for yourself.
The boys arrived at the competition exhausted, without a chance to test Stinky.
Carl Hayden High School,
we're ready to
have 1 minute.
Let's go, guys. Do it. Yeah. Do it. We had no idea if this solution would work.
Thanks to a wild idea, Stinky was working again. The boys had 30 minutes to complete 10 tasks. The college teams had a laser to measure distances. Carl Hayden couldn't afford one. They used a tape measure instead.
The hardest task was to sample the fluid from a barrel with a tube. Most of the teams didn't even attempt it.
When we went straight to it, it just fell into it like it was meant to be or something.
At the awards banquet, they heard something that surprised everyone.
And second place goes to Massachusetts Institute of Technology.
MIT got second place.
I was thinking, who's first? Oh man, who beat MIT? This is gonna be awesome.
First place goes to Carl Hayden High School from Phoenix, Arizona.
It was almost disbelief.
You did it.
Is this a dream or is this for real?
I don't remember walking to the stage. Because, you know, I was just floating, I think.
What started out as a crazy idea turned into something so much more. Today, that high school robotics club has grown exponentially, largely thanks to Freddie.
We're not gonna be a long time.
Knowing that somebody believes in you, even though you don't believe in yourself, even though you doubt that you could do something, I think, you know, if you could find that in somebody, it's a blessing.
It was because of him that Angelica went to Stanford.
Now my husband Juan and I are both engineers in Phoenix. And, I mean, you never know. Maybe my daughter will be one too. And any chance I get, I like to help my favorite teacher inspire future engineers.
It's not doing it because it's a triangle. It's very solid. It doesn't change shape.
So now we want you to come up with different ways to make the bridge stronger so you see the truck in front of you so we can make it across the bridge. You guys want to try that?
Yeah!
All right, let's
do it.
Well, I think they need to try to have more triangles.
There's barely any support going along the bottom.
Yeah, I think they should put a sign and say no trucks allowed.
The screw is not stable, period, because it fell apart. The whole bridge
is not stable at all.
We have to remind ourselves about what it costs.
Yeah, but how about we cross that bridge when we come to it, because I think...
Young minds find new paths. It was not physics alone that led to the Millau Bridge in France. It was art. Young minds will shape the future. Some young engineers have a bold dream to revolutionize transportation. It's called Hyperloop. If they succeed, they'll allow us to travel 700 miles per hour. That's from LA to San Francisco in 30 minutes. By the end of the century, 90% of us will live in cities. An exciting challenge for engineers. The bigger cities get, the smarter they'll need to become.
This new transportation hub in San Francisco will feature a network of wireless sensors. This will make it safer, more energy efficient, and smarter. The more urban we become, the more we need trees, gardens, and places to play.
The word engineer means ingenious. I love being an engineer. I create things from nothing, from a blank sheet of paper. I can change cities. I can change the future.
Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around. Because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for the people to say that we don't want to fight no more. There'll be no more wars, and our children will play.
The joy of engineering the future belongs to the young. What better time to start dreaming big?
Okay, thank you for watching the movie. We're going to have a quick little discussion now, and then you guys are free to go. We should be out by 5. So our first question is general thoughts of the film, and what did you enjoy? If you guys feel more comfortable writing your answers in the chat, that's totally cool. But if you would like to verbalize, then that's encouraged and welcome.
What did you guys like? I know there's only two of you, but.
Okay, I can go. I'll share my answer, and maybe it'll inspire you. Overall, I really enjoyed the film, and I specifically liked how they showed a side of engineering that was more like the underdogs, and it I feel like it was inspirational, and I learned a lot of new things.
Okay. Maybe the next question is yours.
Yeah. Okay, so that segues us into our next question. Did you learn anything new? I know for me, I did not know that there was rice in the Great Wall of China, which I thought was pretty cool.
Okay. For the next question, did this movie change your view of STEM in any way? And does anyone want to answer that? No? Okay. I mean, honestly, it kind of made me feel more comfortable with the field of STEM, if that makes any sense. Like, I feel like everyone thinks of STEM to be, like, very difficult and, like, so rigorous and stuff. But when I watched this movie, it kind of, like, opened my mind on what STEM really is. And it was kind of, like, encouraging to, you know, pursue something in STEM. And it made me more interested in STEM just overall.
All right, last question. How did this movie connect to STEM Week? I don't know whether you guys want to answer in chat, but I can answer. So, like, STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math, and I think it connected to all four, honestly. Like, with engineering, obviously, they were building things, but they needed math in order to calculate how to build those things, technology in order to put them out into the world. And science, just like looking around us using like chemistry or living environments and biology.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Does anyone else have any questions or anything they want to add on to any of the questions? Anything? No? Okay.
I'm going to send the attendance form in chat right now.
Okay.
Yeah, so just make sure you fill that out before you leave, preferably like right now. Yeah.
And yeah, then so you guys can get your points and stuff.
And I hope you have a good rest of STEM week. Hopefully you keep coming to different events because it's good to have people at your events.
And I hope you guys enjoyed today's movie and thank you guys for coming. So just fill out the attendance form and then you're good to go.